Welcome back to the fascinating world of the jeans with Rohini, and today we are going to expand the topic lacoperon. In the last video we have learned about the structure of the lacoperon and the structure of the lac repressor, that is the lac eye. And now today we are going to learn about the regulations by which the lacoperon it is going to be regulated. There are the two means by which the lacoperon it is going to be regulated, and it is the negative inducible type of the regulation, and the second one it is the positive regulation, which may be called as the catabolite repression. Now, before going towards the actual regulations, we have to overview the structure of the lacoperon. Here it is the lacoperon. Okay, lac I, it is the regulatory gene. Okay, next there is a O3, O1 and this O2. Okay, these are the three operators of the lacoperon. There is the CBS, it is a CRP binding site. P, it is the promoter. And here there are the three structural genes, which are the LACZ, LACY and the LACA. So this it is the structure of the lacoperon. Now going towards the first type of the regulation, and that it is the negative inducible. When we have seen about the types of the regulations in the last and the last video, in that we have learned about the negative inducible, and in that negative inducible there are the two stages. First stage it is the repression, and the second stage it is the induction. So here, as the lacoperon it is regulated by the negative inducible type of the regulation, here also there will be the presence of the two stages. First it is a repression, and the second one it is the induction. So the first stage it is the repression. In the repression, what is going to happen? The lac eye it is going to synthesize the repressor. That repressor it is going to form a tetrameric form. This, okay, this diagram, okay, this part of the diagram, it is a lac repressor, and you can see it is a tetramer, and this functional active tetrameric repressor, it is getting and binding to the operator. Just now we have seen that there are the three operators, O1, O2 and the O3. So the repressor it is going to bound to all the three operators simultaneously. Okay, the repressor it is going to bound all the three operators simultaneously, and when it is going to bound to the all the operators simultaneously, it is going to form a loop structure. That is, there is a bending of the DNA. Why this is the bending of the DNA? You are going to observe here, because the location of the operators, here it is the O1, here in the LACZ there is a presence of O2, and in the LACI there is a presence of O3. So these three operators, they are apart from each other, they are far away from each other, and a repressor, okay, a single repressor, it has to bound to the all the three operators simultaneously. So here there is a bending of the DNA, that is a looping of the DNA, so that at a time a repressor it is going to occupy all the three operators. Okay, so in this way, okay, so in this way there is, okay, in this way there is the repression. Second one, okay, the second thing by which there is a repression, which is a most important one, that it is the binding of the repressor to this O1, this O1. Okay, now here when you look at the O1 and the promoter sequences, the promoter sequences and the O1 sequences, they are the overlapping one. The promoter sequences and the O1 sequences, they are overlapping one. And here, this repressor molecule, it is going to bound with the operator at the overlapping sequences. Okay? The overlapping sequences between the promoter and operator, at that site there is the binding of the repressor. Okay, so when the RNA polymerases it is going and binding to the promoter, okay, at that time, as the repressor it has bound to the O1 at the overlapping sequences of the promoter, okay, the binding it will not be a efficient binding, because here O1 it has occupied some of the place of the promoter, so it cannot go further. And also here, oven, it is also occupying the transcriptional star site of the Langer gene. And as the transcriptional star site of the Langer gene, it has been occupied by the oven. And at that site also, the repressor, it is going to bound. That transcriptional start site, it is also not available for the start of the transcription. So, the RNA polymerases, it is inhibited. Okay, the RNA polymerases, it is inhibited to do the transcription as the repressor, it is going to bound at the oven. And here, the main function of the repression, it is done by this oven. So it is not allowing the proper loading of the RNA polymerases over the promoter, and also it is not allowing the RNA polymerases to get further into the structural genes. So here this repressor molecule, okay, this repressor molecule, it is going to stop the transcription, or it is going to do the repression. That is, it is not allowing the expression of the structural genes. Okay, so this, it is the repression, okay, which is going to occur into the negative inducible type of the regulation of the lac operon. Have you understood? I think you have. If you have any comment or if you have any doubt regarding this, you may write into the comment box. Now going towards the next, it is the induction. Okay, so when there will be the induction? When the product of the structural genes, it is required. Okay, the product of the structural genes, it is required. That is, when in the medium there is a presence of lactose and no other carbon sugar or no another sugar it is present at that time. Okay, at that time there has to be the synthesis. Okay, there has to be the synthesis of the product from the structural genes. So what should happen at that time? The repressor, it should get detached from the operator. What should happen? The repressor, it should get detached from the operator. And how it is going to detach from the operator? Here, the small molecule, it is going to come, and that small molecule, it is called as the allolactose. As it is the induction, okay, as it is the induction, in that induction there is an incoming of the molecule, and that it is the inducer, and in the lac operon that inducer it is the allolactose. So the allolactose, it is going to come and it is going to bound to the repressor. Okay, and what it is going to do? It is going to bound with the repressor at the inducer binding site situated into the core domain. This one. Okay. It is an inducer binding site. Okay. It is an inducer binding site and it is present into the core domain. So your allolactose, it is going to come and going to bound with the inducer binding site. And as soon as it is getting bound to the inducer binding site. Okay. Here. This, it is the allolactose and it has bound to the inducer binding site. And as soon as it binds to the inducer binding site, there are the conformational changes into the lac repressor in such a way that the binding between the operator and the repressor, now it is going to abolish. That is the repressor, it is going to be detached from the operator. It is getting removed from the operator by how? By having the conformational change into the repressor. And where it is going to happen? By having or by binding of the repressor to the inducer binding site. Here you can see that it is a hinge region. Okay, it is a hinge region of the active repressor. And now when inducer it has been bound, the hinge region it has rotated. Okay, there is the, suppose here in this way there is your DNA binding domain, this one. Okay, this it is a DNA binding domain, and in this way your repressor has bound to the operator. Okay, so when the inducer it is going to bound to the repressor, at that time the hinge region it is going to rotate, and as it is going to rotate, what is going to happen? the interaction between, okay, there is a no interaction between the operator and the repressor. Okay, due to what? Due to the rotation of the headpiece, due to the rotation of this DNA binding domain, which is done by whom? Which is done by this hinge region. It is like how you are going further and a friend, it is coming from backside, it is going to put his hand on your shoulder and you look back. In the same way, inducer, it is going to bound to the repressor and it is going to change its conformation, it is going to change its head position, and due to that change in the head position, what is going to happen? There is a detachment of the repressor from the operator, and in this way, repressor, it is going to be removed from the operator, and now what you can find that the DNA, now it is a linear DNA, so that the RNA polymerases, it is going to bound to the promoter, and then there is the induction. That is, there is a start of the transcription. So here, when the DNA, it is a bended condition, at that time there will be no transcription. Why? Because for the transcription, a DNA, it should be in a linear position. That is, the promoters, it should not interact with the any another molecules or any another proteins. And here, after binding the inducer, what is happening? This repressor, it is removed from the operators. It is becoming a linear, and also it is going to free the promoter. Okay, it is also going to free the promoter, and as the promoter, it is getting free. Okay, as the promoter, it is getting free. And also the transcriptional start site, it is getting free. The RNA polymerases, it is going to be loaded over the promoter, and there will be the expression of the genes LAC-Z, LAC-Y and the LAC-A. In this way, there is the induction. So, in the induction, there is, okay, in the induction, there is start of the transcription. But the efficiency of the transcription, it is not very high. Okay, so to increase the efficiency of the transcription, there has to be the second type of the regulation, and that it is the positive regulation. And you know that in the positive regulation, the regulatory protein which is going to come, it is called as the activator. In the lac operon, okay, in the lac operon, that regulatory protein, that activator, it is a CRP, or it is also called as the CAP. CRP, it is a cyclic AMP receptor protein, and the CAP, it is a catabolite activator protein. Okay, the two names for the same protein, it has been given. Here the cyclic AMP, it is the inducer molecule. Okay, cyclic AMP, it is an inducer molecule, and this cyclic AMP, okay, this cyclic AMP, it is getting bound to the CRP. Okay, the binding site for the cyclic AMP, it is a CRP. Here the CRP, it is the activator which is in a inactive form, and to make that CRP active one, cyclic AMP, it is getting bound to the CRP and making a complex. It is called as the cyclic AMP CRP complex. Okay, it is forming the complex, cyclic AMP CRP complex, and now the activator CRP, it is the active one. Okay, so it is going and binding to the site, it is the CBS. It is what? CRP binding site. So what will happen? Your cyclic AMP CRP complex, now it is getting bound to the CBS, and as it has been bound to the CBS, it is allowing the efficient loading of the RNA polymerases over the promoter. Okay, what it is going to do? It is allowing the loading of the RNA polymerases over the promoter, so there will be the transcription of the structural genes. Okay, that is the CRP. Okay, CRP, which is an activator, it has been made active by the cyclic AMP, and here the complex, it is the cyclic AMP CRP complex. That cyclic AMP CRP complex, it is getting bound to the CBS, allowing the loading of the RNA polymerases over the promoter. Okay, so there will be the increase in efficiency of transcription. Okay, so in this way there is the positive regulation. So the lacoperon, it is regulated by the two means. First one, it is the negative inducible regulation. Second one, it is a positive regulation, and it is also called as an catabolite repression. That part we are going to study in detail in the next video. Okay, so if you have any comment or if you have any doubt regarding the topic, or you want anything else from me, you can write into your comment box. Okay, so if you have liked the video, please subscribe and also share the videos so that together we can spread the knowledge. Thank you.